Welcome to Plants vs. Zombies, this is episode 7. We're doing 3-4. I feel like we've done this before, but I don't think we have. Oh, yes, that's right, we just got the tanglekelp. Okay, yeah, that's right. So, we need these guys. We're gonna definitely need the tanglekelp. The tanglekelp's gonna make our lives so much easier. Because it will basically deal with these guys. What it does is, it's an aquatic plant that pulls a zombie underwater. So, these guys up here, the snorkel zombies and the duckling zombies, they will basically instantly die. And then for the rest we want, maybe, I guess we'll go with the panic button plan. Yeah, we'll go with the panic button plan. And then we'll do this there. Okay. So. Let's get going. And we're going to plant ourselves sunflower. Now the idea here is, just like before, we're going to try and fortify as much as we can before the zombies arrive. But now, what we're going to do for the rows where there's water, we're going to try and put as much tanglekelp down as possible, because the tanglekelp's pretty useful. Hello. Okay. I should maybe have taken potato mines, thinking about it. Well. Oh, pardon me. I've been eating the equivalent of American beef jerky, and right now I'm having issues with some of it. Okay, no problem. Right, and we're gonna do that again. Oh, sun. I'm missing sun. That's terrible. Oh well. Okay, we're just gonna start off like we normally would. I'll try and get, although I don't know if it'll happen, I'll try and get to a point where I can basically start covering these two lanes. Oh, we're gonna get there, it's not gonna be a problem. Okay, alright, well, there. And now we're gonna start building on the water. There we go. Oh, dear. That is kind of a problem. Because I'm not going to make it in time to put down a 3-peater. Well, maybe. Let's see. I might get there, but I don't know if it'll be enough time to do damage to all of them. No, it's not. Okay, that was terrible. P.S. Oh, I guess it doesn't help that I'm not making more sunflowers, does it? May need a squash here. In fact, this board is going pretty badly, I dare say. So far, anyway. Well, I guess this is what happens when you take the expensive plan. It doesn't work. Okay. So, now I need to make a decision. And I think the decision I'm going to make is to put that guy there. If only so I can cover that and get this guy dead. Oh, that's bad. Okay. And he'll run into that, which is awesome. That's less awesome though. Oh no. Oh dear. Yeah, you gotta watch out for those guys, they run real fast. And unfortunately I didn't have a way of dealing with them immediately. It's looking a bit better now. I'm considerably less worried. There's gonna be three waves, it's gonna be kind of long. Oh, I heard a bucket head. I hear bucket head. That's very bad. And a swimmer. It's all going wrong now. Okay, so here's tanglekelp. I should maybe have put down... Yeah, I should have. He's gonna get killed, but it's gonna be close. Okay, so you saw the tanglekelp take out that guy. The only problem with tanglekelp is that it's slow to refresh. So what I'm gonna do is this and this. So we'll bring him out of the water. This bottom row here is having issues. Oh god. And this is why the panic button plan sometimes is helpful. So what do I think we need? Okay, well, yeah. Let's put down a there. Okay. Now I'm a lot happier. The problem is that because the tanglekelp's got such a slow refresh rate, you can't rely on the tanglekelp to be there for you all the time. Ah, where's my mouse? Get here. Thank you. My mouse doesn't like me. Hey, it's okay. That's good. Let's put another one down here. In fact, I might actually bulldoze the squash and put another. Yeah, we're good. We're okay. Bulled over there. Wow. For a bit, that was scary, actually. Let's stop putting tanglekelp up here. Now you can see the tanglekelp, it refreshes pretty slowly, so you sort of want to be mindful of that. I want to put a guy over here so I can cover more of the middle rows. There. My cursor. that bottom row seems problematic. Actually, there we go. Why am I destroying that? Because it had a bucket head zombie, and that was gonna go terribly for me in the long run. Yay, tanglekelp doing its job. Let's put that back down. Oh, that's wonderful. Actually, that worked out real well. I didn't even look. I just put the tanglekelp down, and shazam, it was in the right row. We got another one. They seem to want to come on that. There, now I can replace that guy. There. Oh, buckethead zombie. Not so good. Yeah. They seem to always want to show up on the top row. Oh, there's a couple showing up on the bottom row. Good stuff. I just want a nice couple of walnuts, and then I'll be happy. Because the minute I can get walnuts over here, we're all covered and we're good, so... There, walnut, especially there. Wow, bucket heads galore. That's not good at all. The cone heads are one thing, I mean, but double bucket heads on that last row? Man. And the thing is, like, you know, you've seen the pea shooters and repeaters and all those guys, they can't shoot past one guy, so you've literally got to deal with the first bucket head before you can deal with the second one. Which just makes it, like, kind of a pain. There we go, now I'm happy. Now, kind of if you wanted to, you could just go in there, like, maybe squashes all the way up in the front, or extra three-peaters, which actually may not be such a bad idea. Let's do that. Overkill, how does it work? Wow. I should have been a little bit more strategic there and put those on either side. But I think we're gonna be mostly okay. We'll drop a bomb. Maybe here? I suppose. Ah. There we go. Ooh! Key. Key's very important. Now you can visit Crazy Dave's shops. So let's do that. Hey, you found my car key. You know what that means. Crazy Dave's Tiddlywinks is open for business. Have a look, see if you can't find something you like. Okay, so, like I said, the slots get exponentially more expensive. We got 4,500. We're gonna need another 500 before we can buy that. But over here, we've got some cool upgrades. These are twin sunflowers. They're very good. This is the Gatling Pea. That's also very good. This stuff, are extra line of defense and pool levels. But I think, if I'm not mistaken, that they're only there for one level. This is the Gun Rake. It takes up the first zombie that steps in it. It lasts for three levels. That's terrible, because it only lasts for three rounds. But as, we go, Dave will get more stuff, okay? There's nothing here that I can afford or want to buy, so we're just gonna move along. Next level. Okay. Funny thing about the zombie process, sometimes it make them come out real little. Real little, and real mean. Okay, so, defend your shins! Okay, so, this is basically, I mean, look at this. It's crazy. They're tiny zombies, they're very fast, you have to be careful of this. And it's basically just a level where you have to plant. I see this guy, we're gonna do plant, plant, no we're not, we're gonna do plant, plant, there, there. So, there. I'm not gonna be terribly picky about it right yet. But towards the end, maybe I will. I wanna save that, but I might not. Actually, I'm not going to, because I see trouble brewing over there. You can go over here. Let's stop building from the top. Oh, and there's a whole line going that way. Oh, God. He's trouble. I mean, they may be small, but they're still trouble. And now we're caught with our pants down. That's awesome. Here, there. And there's another guy coming at the top. And that's kind of bad. Well, he can chew on... Yeah, there. He can chew on the walnut for a while. I should actually be building things for these little rows. Which is not so great. Problem. I'm terrified of those guys. Like, they're the bane of my existence. Yeah. There. Oh. Oh. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Whoa, little buddy. Yeah. Okay. You have that. Man. This is all happening too quickly. And since you're busy doing that, there. Okay. I'm a little happier now because we've got something covering every row. I don't like... Well, I don't like this row. For a start. That row's okay. That row's kind of covered. Oh, nice spot little guy underwater. Haha, but he's going to run into my evil plan. We should probably put more pea shooters on these rows here, because, oh, I'm gonna miss the point. and we'll just go, well, yeah, we'll build more lines of defense. There. I'm not actually being very good about defending these bottom rows, am I? No, I'm being, then. Oh god. Okay, here, let's fix that. We'll add another line of defense here. I'm bad about it. I'm pulled downwards. And sometimes that doesn't work out for me. I'm kind of loath to put anything out there because it's just gonna get eaten. Wait. Yeah. Make a spot. There. Yeah. No. Bad. Eat that instead. Thanks. Much better. Okay. So now we are okay. This should be good. Because I'm building slowly but surely, I'm building a stash of cherry bombs at the back. Which is kind of what I want. Oh, final wave. I didn't realize it. There. And possibly, if I get lucky, I can add something on this row. But I don't think it's gonna matter. No, actually it didn't. Oh, that's pretty good. Okay, I'm happy with that. Cherry bomb. It's one of my favorite powers up in the game. Well, I say it's a power, but it's not actually. Destroys an entire lane of zombies. But we're gonna see that next week. Thank you so much. I'm sorry these episodes are so short, but I'm trying not to go over 20 minutes because I'm terrified of that now. So thank you so much for watching. This is episode 7 of Plants vs. Zombies. Next week we will take the entire lane of zombie jalapeno thing for a spin. I'll see you all next week. Have a great week, folks. Goodbye.